This video is funded by the Children's Bureau.
Data-driven decision-making is a way to determine a course of action based on quality data. It uses data systematically and intelligently to assess, test, and improve a program, activity, or process. Data-driven decision-making is about getting the right data to the right people at the right times to effectively use the data to problem-solve and improve performance. Data-driven decision-making can help child welfare organizations identify and respond to emerging trends and needs among children and families. We will show how a fictional organization, Greene County Department of Human Services, set out to improve permanency for children and youth by increasing the number of available foster and adoptive homes using data-driven decision-making. First, you need a theoretical and logical framework, typically represented by a theory of change, which is a roadmap that articulates how and why your proposed service strategy will achieve its long-term goals, along with the indicators that will help you measure and track progress. You will also need high-quality data for your indicators, as well as measures or metrics of fidelity that indicate implementation is occurring as it was originally designed. It's a good idea to work with your organization's information technology staff to identify existing data sources that will give you the information you need, along with any needed enhancements or additions to your data system. One system feature to explore with your IT staff is a data dashboard, a visual tool to display all of your important indicator data in real time. Online dashboards are effective for fast and easy interpretation of data. However, you can also track indicators over time using spreadsheets and simple graphs that are consistently updated.
Greene County Department of Human Services wanted to increase the number of available foster and adoptive homes with the ultimate long-term goal of increasing permanent placements for children and youth. As part of its theory of change, Greene County outlined an outcomes chain that linked new and expanded recruitment activities with greater inquiries from potential foster parents, which in turn would lead to more families entering and completing the licensing process. To get started, the Greene County implementation team developed recruitment activities, including a website, media advertisements, and community-based events, while the data support team began assessing and modifying its data system to track the new data.
For more information about data-driven decision-making, please visit the Children's Bureau website at www.acf.hhs.gov/cb. This video was developed by James Bell Associates on behalf of the Children's Bureau, Administration for Children and Families, ACF, U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, HHS, under contract number HHSP233201500133I, order number HHSP233370001T. Its contents are the sole responsibility of the author and do not necessarily represent the official views or policies of the Children's Bureau, ACF, or HHS.